What's good, everybody? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. Today, guys, we're going to be talking about solving equations, and we're going to explain what an equation actually is and the steps to solve. But before we get started today, guys, I'm going to ask you guys to like our video, subscribe to our channel, and to leave any comments on future videos you'd like to see. So let's get started for today, guys. So remember that an equation is just a mathematical expression with an equal sign. So let's say we have the first equation, m plus 10 is equal to 12. So I think the biggest thing with solving equations is really understanding what's going on. So what they're saying to us is that you're going to add a number to 10. And that number, once you add it to 10, is going to give us a final answer of 12. We all could probably figure out that 10 plus 2 is 12. But how do we show this mathematically? That's what I'm going to show you guys. So in math, your teacher normally tells you, hey, when we're solving equations, we're going to do inverse operations. But I want to explain that in an easier form. So what we want to do is work backwards. And this is what I mean. So if we're looking at problem number one and we want to solve for our m, the question says m plus 10 is equal to 12. So when we work backwards, we're going to take 10, right? Instead of adding it, we want to subtract 10. So with equations, right, we're going to subtract that 10 from itself. And the cardinal rule is what you do on one side of the equation, you want to do on the other. And once we apply subtracting 10 on both sides, we'll notice that we will get m is equal to 2. And once we plug that back into our original equation, we could check it and we'll know that that was the correct answer. So let's look at a second problem now. So let's say we have a problem, and in our second problem, it says 7y is equal to 91. Now, guys, understand this. They're saying to us, hey, Mr. Peters, we have 7, and we're going to multiply by a certain number. You know, that's why we have the variable y. We're going to multiply by an unknown number, and that product is going to be 91. The answer is 91. So guys, think about the inverse operation, right? The opposite operation to multiplication. This is what I mean when I say work backwards. So I know if I multiply 7 in a certain number, I'm going to get 91. So what about if I go ahead and divide, right? I want to get this variable by itself. So I'm going to divide 7 by itself. And I'm going to do that same step on the other side. And I notice that when I divide 91 by 7, y is going to be equal to 13. So what we're saying is 7 times 13 is equal to 91. And when we check this, right, we just plug it back in, 13 for y, we are going to get 91 as an answer. So guys, just remember, when we're solving equations, inverse operations, we're just saying, hey, we're going to work backwards by undoing these operations, okay? So let's take a look at one problem that has to do with subtraction, and we're going to do the formidable fraction. So let's look at this one, right? So in our next problem, we have g minus 9 is equal to negative 2. So what they're saying is that when you take 9 away from a certain number, it's going to give us a negative 2. So let's think about it, guys. If we want to get g by itself, right, we're going to have to move that 9. And if we're working backwards, right, the opposite of subtracting 9 is adding 9. So let's go ahead and add 9 to itself. right? And then we're going to go on the opposite side of the equal sign and apply that same step. And after 9 cancels out, right, because negative 9 plus 9 is 0, g is now equal to negative 2 plus 9. And once we get our answer of 7, we're going to plug it back in just to double check, right? So I'm saying that 7 minus 9 is equal to negative 2. And when I simplify, I will get negative 2 is equal to negative 2. We know that that is the correct answer. All right. So let's go on to our last problem for today with solving equations, right? One-step equations. Nice introduction for us today. So we have A over 2 is equal to 18. So what they're saying to us is, hey, you're going to have a certain number. And once you divide that number by 2, your answer will be 18. So guys, let's think about it, right? The opposite operation, if we're undoing these things, we're working backwards. What is the opposite of dividing by 2? Yeah, we're going to multiply by 2 so that we could have this A absolutely by itself. So I'm going to multiply by 2, right? 2 over 1. Those 2s cancel. We're left with just A. And when I go on the other side, I'm going to multiply 18 times 2. And once I do that, I'm going to get an answer of 36. Now, what we're saying is that A is 36. So let's see. When we divide 36 by 2, will that give us 18? And once I simplify my problem, we will notice that that is the correct answer. So guys, remember, when we're solving equations, one-step equations, right? We want to work backwards and undo the problem and the operations in the problem. So thank you guys so much for joining us today. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. Join us next time when we talk more about solving two-step equations.